I was really persuaded by a chocolate muffin. And that makes me think, like, where was you at mentally during this game? You know, for the show, I actually was, I thought it was a scam when I first seen it, actually. Yeah, I thought it was a scam, if I'm gonna be honest. Squid Game, the challenge. I was like, no. And then I actually had somebody from the casting team reach out to me and, you know, sent me an email, told me to give them a call. And then when I still thought it was still a scam. Mm. And I did not know what to really expect, honestly. Because it is a Korean drama, yeah. I don't know if I'm going there to compete necessarily, or am I going there to, you know, get into some drama. So I didn't know what to expect, really. But it started all from a message, a random email, for sure. That was my exact reaction, because I was so mad at the person who chose the star, and he was so okay with it.
Yeah.
So he was so okay with it, and then like, that star was not easy. You know, you have different nooks and crannies you have to get into, and I'm just like, fuck, man. But thank God we all had a solution. We got a solution. And the solution was to fill your mouth up like this with saliva.
Yeah.
Take the cookie out and just right in the tin. Literally fill it up and put the cookie back in there. It was disgusting. So I do not blame Netflix for cutting that whole part out. I, you know, looking back at it, I cannot believe that I was really persuaded by a chocolate muffin. And I keep saying that. Like, I was really persuaded by a chocolate muffin. And that makes me think, like, where was you at mentally during this game? Because, like, everybody obviously sees, even the viewers can obviously see.
Yeah.
It's a setup. It's a trap. So I was so close to picking up the phone, because I was supposed to pick up the phone in the first place. Mm. They didn't show that part. I was supposed to get the phone in the first place. So as soon as he said chocolate muffin, you know, we already got burgers and fries, and my taste buds are like screaming for more. I need something. I need something sweet. I need something up in here to take my mind off of this goddamn challenge. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I almost picked up the phone, and I swear to God, and I promise you, if I did not have the other players screaming my name and telling me no, I think I probably would have picked up that phone. If they would have remained quiet, I probably would have picked up that phone, without a doubt. People don't understand that I sat down with him in a group, and we all were in alliance in the beginning.
Yeah.
When he sees me as a threat, and he said it himself, you see me as a threat. Why? Oh, for all the obvious reasons.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I definitely can see him taking a good look at me and being like, damn, he's everything I'm not.
Yeah.
So, I don't blame him for the threatening feeling that I'm giving him. So, was I expecting him to say my number? Yes. Absolutely. Absolutely. I can spot a hater from a mile away. It ain't nothing. It ain't nothing. So, as soon as he did it, I'm like, you know what? It is what it is, player. Because I already knew. You know what? Let me just say this now that I have this moment. Big giggles. Big giggles to your elimination that next episode. To when you got your ass beat in that marbles game. And then, like, Good night. So I'm actually satisfied. Okay. With the way everything went down. There was rumored issues. I did not have like the full verified information about people hooking up on the show, but it was not. They had condoms in the dorms, but they kicked them out. I'm confused. So confused. Yeah. So, but I tell you this though. They had some real, it was giving crazy because we had a lot of attractive people in there.
Yeah.
A lot. There, oh God, yes. But as far as that goes, but there was a lot of romance drama going on in the dorms though, which was so nice to, yes. And also, you know, there was a love triangle going on in the beginning of the show, and everybody thought that these people were going to be main characters of the show, but they ended up not getting shown not once, which is very interesting to me. They didn't even show them in Red Light, Green Light. They didn't show them at all. Well, they showed the guy, but the girls, they didn't show them. Yeah.
Darius, please spill some name. Please.
I don't want to spill no names. Brighton knows what I'm talking about. Alex knows what I'm talking about. That's all I'm gonna say. This is insane. This is crazy. A lot of money has been put into this, and I can't believe this is freaking real.
Yeah.
This is the real deal. I'm actually here. I'm actually in Squid Game, and it's official. I think they definitely had an advantage to the point of communication. You know, it was really easy for people to connect with them on a different level, because if you were cool with Trey, you were cool with Leanne, and vice versa. So they came as a one-on-one package and everybody loved them. So that's definitely an advantage, because not only are people going to have a type of sympathy for you in the game, but it's weird. So everything is about perspective. So I think it was an advantage. You know, since the show aired, I've definitely been in the process of really wrapping my head around being on the show, for sure. I didn't think that, because I thought that life would go back to normal after the show, and when everything was quiet, everything was good. But once the show came out, I didn't realize how much people are actually watching me. So I'm like, I'm going to the gym, and like people are like, were you on Squid Game? Are you Darius from Squid Game? And on socials, people like finding me. It's really fun. It's really fun. It's exciting talking and connecting with so many new people. It's freaking awesome. It's freaking awesome. But at the same time, it's a little overwhelming. Yeah. So I'm learning. I'm learning at the end of the day, for sure. Okay. Everybody watching this, this is Darius the Barbarian from Squid Game Netflix. And I just want to say a great shout out and thank you to all of you. Please follow me at Darius the Barbarian and be expecting my new album, Body Gospel. My new album, Body Gospel, coming out between February and March, prior to my tour in India. So Body Gospel 2024, February and March, India tour, February and March, and it's gonna get hot, it's gonna get popping. And if you have not watched Squid Game yet, please head on over to Netflix.